Hello students, myself Mamta Sharma and I am here to tell you about political parties. For most ordinary citizens, democracy is equal to political parties. If you travel in remote parts of our country and speak to the less educated citizens, you could come across people who may not know anything about our constitution or about the nature of the government, but chances are there that they would know something about our political parties. Let us first answer what political parties are. Political party is a group of people who come together to contest election and hold power in the government. The members of political parties agree on some policies and programs for the society with a view to promote the collective good. From the meaning, we had come across some of the characteristics that political parties constitute. A political party is an organized group of people. The organized group of people believe in common principles and common goals. Its objectives revolve around seeking political power through collective efforts. It employs constitutional and peaceful methods in seeking control over the government through elections. While in power, it translates its declared objectives into governmental policies. The parties reflect fundamental political divisions in the society. The next question is, what does a political party do? Basically, political parties fill political offices and exercise political power. Parties do so by performing a series of functions, like they nominate candidates during elections. They campaign to obtain support for their candidates in the election. They place objectives and programs before the voters through their manifestos. The party securing majority in election form the government and implement the policies. Those not in power form opposition and keep a constant check on the government. The parties, when in minority, form opposition. They constantly put pressure on the government for proper governance. The leaders educate people and help in formulating and shaping public opinions. They articulate people's demand and convey them to the government. They provide a linkage between people and governmental institutions. In a democracy, any group of citizens is free to form a political party. So, the question arises that how many major or effective parties are good for a democracy. So let us talk about the party system. First, one party system. In some countries, only one party controls and runs the government. For example, in China, such party provides stable government. Long-term plannings can be formed and executed. Less money is spent on the elections. At the same time, democracy is most likely to be eroded and dictatorship can arise. Such system does not provide any meaningful choice to the people. Another system is two-party system. In some countries, power is shared between two main parties like USA and UK. Government with such system is easy to fall and become stable. Dictatorship of cabinet can prevail whenever there is much possibility that it could divide the nation into two campaigns. The next is multi-party system. Under such system, several parties join hands for the purpose of contesting election and winning power. Like in India, the multi-party system often appears very messy and leads to political instability. It is most expensive system also. At the same time, this system allows a variety of interests and opinions to enjoy political representation. Thank you, students, for your time. Just try to learn and understand each content.